Boker Tov, Shabbat Shalom, good morning. We're here at the Kollel Ahavat Israel in San Diego, in La Jolla. Thank you everybody for joining us. Today we're going to have a special class that we started a couple months ago. It's called Acharit HaYamim, the end of days. So, what is the end of days? You know, the question is always asked, what does it mean really, the end of days? Ma ze Acharit HaYamim? מה אנחנו מבינים כששומעים את המילים אחרית הימים? אז אומר הזוהר דבר מאוד 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 מעניין. כמובן, אנחנו רואים שבזוהר כתוב, בבראשית ב' בחיי שרה, אומר הזוהר, אמר רבי יוסף, וכי ימות המשיח ותחיית המתים אינם אחד? So the Zohar, רבי יוסף in the Zohar ask a question. Is the days of Mashiach and the days of resurrections, are they one of the kind? So, the Zohar answer says, no, it's not. You know, days of Mashiach and resurrection of the dead are not the same thing. It's not exactly the same thing. The Zohar explained, that's what we learned. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai taught them and he said, בית המקדש קודם לקיבוץ גלויות, קיבוץ גלויות קודם לתחיית המתים, ותחיית המתים האחרון שבכולם. So the Zohar says that actually, as we said, the days of Mashiach and the resurrection of the days, that are not one of a kind, or not the same time, is not the same period, and the same exactly beginnings. So it says each one follows a certain event and amazing, you know, redemption. So he says the first thing is Bet HaMikdash. He said first the temple will be built before the gathering of the people of Israel from all over the world, and the gathering of all the people of Israel will be before the resurrection of the dead, and the resurrection of the dead will be the last one. He says, Minayin, where do we learn this from? He says, from the verse in Tehillim, in chapter 146, he said, Bonei Yerushalayim Adonai, Nitche Yisrael Lechanes, Harofe Lishvur Elev, Umechabesh La'atzvotam. So the order will be Beit HaMikdash first, before the gathering of the people of Israel, and before the resurrection of the dead. So we see here that Zohi Tchiyat HaMetim, when he says Mechabesh La'atzvotam, Zohi Tchiyat HaMetim, this is the resurrection of the dead. So he says, Shehi HaRofe L'Shvur Elev, Al Metehem, Bonei Yerushalayim Techila, V'Acharav Nitche Yisrael Yechanes, V'HaRofe L'Shvur Elev, Acharon Al HaKol. So what's going to happen in those days? So the Zohar will explain the following. He says, 40 Shana, קודם הקיבוץ גליות לתחיית המתים. The first thing will happen is the gathering of the people of Israel from all over the world. That will be 40 years before the resurrection of the dead. So we see here something amazing. It says, 40 השנה הללו, מה הם מעשיהם? What's going to happen in these 40 years? The Zohar says. אמר רב כהנא, אמר רב ברוקה, מקיבוץ גליות עד תחיית המתים, כמה צרות, כמה מלחמות התעוררו על ישראל. He says that from the gathering of the people of Israel, there will be a lot of problems, both in the world and in Israel. We see today, by the way, the everything that's happening in Israel with the election, everything's happening around Israel with all the masses of soldiers and weapons and missiles and gathering all the way from Turkey through Lebanon, through Jordan, through Syria, through Iran. You know, we see, you know, happening right now. That kind of leading into this time of the Acharit HaYamim. So as we said, what's going to happen? It says, Rav Kahana says, מקיבוץ גליות עד תחיית המתים, a lot of problems. This is the first 40 years that will come before the gathering of the people of the gathering of the people of Israel and the resurrection of the dead. So he says, בעת ההיא ימלא את עמך כל הנמצא כתוב בספר. רבי יהודה אומר כאן, התבררו והתלבנו והצרפו רבים. He says, you know, in those days when the problems coming upon Israel in the world, there is, who will be the one that be saved, right? It says, כל הנמצא כתוב בספר, בספר החיים. You know, when we just passed Yom Kippur and Hoshana Rabbah, and you know, there's to be written in the book of life, those are the ones that will survive the, what we call, the chaos that will ensue with the Milchemet Gog and Magog, with the wars of Gog and Magog. We are really at the end of it right now, as the Chafetz Chaim will teach us that the first war was in the beginning of the century, the second one is the Second World War, which include the Holocaust, and now we see the about to erupt, a Third World War. So it says here that all these problems will happen until the end of the 40 years, and will commence at the resurrection of the dead. שעברו הצרות עד תחיית המתים 40 שנה, the Zohar says. And it says here in the Zohar, in the book of Shemot, it says, אשרי מי שיזדמן לו וימצא באותו הזמן, משום שאותו שיעמוד באותו זמן באמונה, יזכה לאותו אור של שמחת המלך. ועל אותו זמן כתוב, in the book of Zechariah, וצרפתי כצורף את הכסף ובחנתיו נבחון את הזהב. So he says here, who will be the one that will survive Gog and Magog and will be, you know, the people that will remain after the 40 years of chaos? As we said, what comes first? You know, as we said in the beginning, the question was asked, is the days of Mashiach and the resurrection of the dead are one of a kind? It's not. It says, Bet HaMikdash come before the Kibbutz Galiot, the gathering of the people of Israel. The gathering of the people of Israel will come before the resurrection of the dead, and the resurrection of the dead will be the last one. So it says, people that believe in it, that believe in Mashiach, that close to Hashem, and believe that they're, you know, one of the people that will be here after all, those are the ones that will remain and be saved. It says, לאחר שאותן צרות התעררו על ישראל, וכל העמים ומלכיהם התייעצו כאחד עליהם, ומעוררים כמה גזרות רעות וכולם עולים בעצה אחת. He says that, you know, in those days, all the nation of the world, we go against Israel. You know, now we see that, you know, we have America, of course, not all America, just Trump and his good friends that supporting Israel. We have, unfortunately, even a lot of Jewish senators really support the Muslim and the Arabs and Iran and don't support the Jews, don't support Israel. You know, we started with John Kerry, is a Jewish guy that he went with Obama and all his buddies to do the deal with Iran, right? This is amazing. Like you see right now today, a shift and all those, you know, senators that go against Trump and they go against Israel, you know? I'm not, you know, here citing any sides of politics, but we just see exactly the Acharit HaYamim, the prophecies of the end of days, of these days, that's coming together to fruition. And it's exactly what it says. It says that those nations, all the nations, you know, right now, even though Trump is for Israel, but in reality, he can be voted out in 1 year or 1 year and a half, all of a sudden, you have both America, Iran, all of them against Israel. So it says here in the Zohar that לאחר שאותן צרות עררו על ישראל, כל העמים ומלכיהם התייעצו כאחד עליהם ומעוררים כמה גזרות רעות וכולם עולים בעצה אחת. They all will up against Israel and have this צרה. The Zohar say, יבוא צרה על צרה. There will be so many problems for Israel in those last years. And it says they will be so bad that the chaos that will ensue against Israel, you will forget, you know, the last year from those years, you know, that you are in them, as if like, you know, the thing that was so bad 2 years ago will not be bad today. And he says, only after these 40 years of chaos, you know, we are, I think, from what I see and what our sages say, today we are really in the midst of those 40 years as we see the chaos around the world. And it says at the end of that, something will incredible happen in the world. The Zohar says that a pillar of fire will show up in the sky. It says, אז יתראה עמוד אש אחד עומד מלמעלה למטה 40 יום, וכל עמי הארץ רואים אותו. The Zohar says that, you know, when those 40 years will end, all of a sudden there'll be a pillar of fire, a pillar of fire that would be from the heavens to earth. Every nation in the world will see that. All the people of the world will see this pillar of fire standing, and it will be standing for 40 days. And those days will be תעורר מלך המשיח לצאת מתוך גן עדן מאותו מקום שנקרא כאן ציפור, ויתעורר בארץ הגליל. So the Zohar says that in those 40 days of the pillar of the fire that the whole world will see, there will be מלך המשיח. Who is king? מלך המשיח, the king of משיח. They say it's actually משיח בן דוד. משיח בן דוד, as we know, will be the king of משיח. And he will come out from the Garden of Eden. And you know, the Garden of Eden on earth is hidden from us. That's where Hashem put Adam and Eve originally. And we see today that Hashem, I mean, the Zohar tells us here that the Mashiach will come from this portion of the land that nikra Kan Tzipor. Kan Tzipor, you know, Kuf Nun Tzipor. This is really, as we know, the mitzvah of Shiluach HaKan, but of course this here speaks of the actual location, and it says that it will be in the Galilee of Israel. V'itaorer be'eretz ha'galil. Mipnei pachad Adonai zehu oto rogez shel kol ha'olam mehader geono zeh ha'mashiach. He says the world will fear from Hashem, and from that, you know, anger that Hashem had about the people of the world, and unfortunately some of the Jewish people that don't keep Torah or go against, you know, the fellow man, like we see today in the election of Israel, the war is against religion, really. We see today the most amazing chaos in the government of Israel. All of them except the religious party and the right party that want to keep and maintain a Jewish state, all of them do not want a Jewish state. It's funny, there is right now, it's funny, it's not funny, it's sad. There is two Binyamin fighting. There is Binyamin Netanyahu and Binyamin Gantz. You know, the two of them, you know, Chas v'Chalila, we see that Binyamin Gantz has people around him that all they want to do. So we see here something amazing. We see that HaKadosh Baruch Hu revealed to Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai what's going to happen in these days. And בקומו לארץ הארץ שיקום ויתגלה בארץ הגליל, he says, he will come, the Mashiach, the King Mashiach, מלך המשיח, will be revealed in the Galilee portion of Israel. And why is it in the Galilee? Because that was the first place that was destroyed when חס וחלילה, the people of Israel, when there was the land of Israel in the times of the temple, that was the first place that the Kedusha was destroyed. ולכן התגלה שם ראשון לכל מקום, משם יעורר קרבות לכל העולם. You know, we know the word Armageddon, right? Armageddon is come from Megiddo. Arm in Megiddo. There is a valley of Megiddo, which is in the Galilee, in the portion of Israel. It says this is where the war will start from all the nations. It will be the pinpoint of the wars against Israel and other nations together. And it says that this war will take 12 months. אחר 12 חודש יזדקף אותו אור בין שמיים וארץ וישרה בארץ הגליל. You know, we spoke about the pillar of fire that will come down from the heavens for 40 days. And this pillar will move then, will move into the Galilee after 12 months of war. And וישרה בארץ הגליל ששם הייתה ראשית גלות ישראל. The first exile of Israel came from the Galilee. אז אנחנו רואים פה שבאמת כל עניין של מלך המשיח ועמוד האש ומתחילת המתים, הכל יתחיל קודם כל בגליל. ואז it says, ושם יתגלה מאותו אור של כאן ציפור ושב למקומו. ואותו יום תזדעזע הארץ כמו מקדם וסוף השמיים עד סוף השמיים. ואז יראו וידעו כל העולם שהרי התגלה מלך המשיח בארץ הגליל. He says, in that day, תזדעזע כל הארץ. You know, that means major earthquake. We know that in days of Mashiach, there'll be an earthquake that will split the Mount of Olives into half. And water will come out. You know, we have the stone, Even Ashtia, right? Shtia is not from drinking, it's the Tashtit. Is what, you know, was put there to stop the water from below to come out to the world. This earthquake will split Mount Olives, and the water will gush and will fill up all the way to, of course, the Dead Sea and continue on to the Big Sea, they call it. And from that point, they say that the whole world will see that the Mashiach is here and he arrived, Be'ezat Hashem, in the Galilee. So they say in the beginning, כשמשיח, בן דוד, מלך המשיח יגיע, there'll be actually two משיחים. There'll be משיח בן יוסף. Our sages explained to us that he will be the one that carry all the wars, and then will come משיח בן דוד to lead the world. And משיח בן דוד will be the king of the world. It will commence in Israel in the Galilee, and then the entire world, nations by nation, will come and join the Jewish people and ask to be led by Melech HaMashiach. He says, "V'itkansu elav kol elu she'oskim b'Torah ve'hem me'atim ba'olam." He said, the first people that will gather to the Melech HaMashiach, yavo anashim she'mitaskim b'Torah. Be'ezat Hashem, I hope to be there with you and gathering in front of King HaMashiach, Be'ezat Hashem. בדרך אגב, המילה משיח זה שם חי, נכון? משיח, there is life there. Life when the Mashiach comes, speaking of the resurrection of the dead. He says that בזכות תינוקות של בית רבן התחזק כוחו להתגבר, וזהו סוד האפרוחים. ואם לא ימצאו אלו, הרי התינוקות שיושבים בתוקף אימם ויונקים, כמו שנאמר, בישעיה כפחת גמולי מחלב עתיקי משדיים, והיינו. או ביצים שבשביל אלה שורה שכינה עם ישראל בגלות. So he says that, you know, in the merit of the young children that study Torah, when we have today yeshivot and chadarim and bet midrash, when we have the young children that pray and study, those are the ones that give us the merit and the Mashiach to exist and have the merit to be resurrected and to be saved. Those are the one, it says, even, you know, the tinok, as we said, tinok is from the word tikkun, right? They come to do a tikkun. They are the one that has no sins, right? Those are the purest of mankind before chas v'chalila any sin. He says the Melech HaMashiach will start in their merit, and they are allowing the Shekhinah to reside on the people of Israel. The Melech HaMashiach yatchil v'yichnos ha-galut misof ha-olam v'ad sof ha-olam. It says that Melech HaMashiach, Mashiach ben David, will start gathering all the Jewish people from, Jewish and non-Jewish, from the ends of all of the world, from all four corners of the end. כמו שנאמר, in the book of Devarim, אם יהיה נדחך בקצה השמיים, it says that even if you are all the way at the corners, the four corners of the world, Hashem would gather you. מאותו יום כל האותות והניסים והגבורות שעשה הקדוש ברוך הוא במצרים יעשה אותם לישראל, כמו שנאמר in Micha, in the book of Micha chapter 7, he says כי מי צאתך מארץ מצרים הראינו נפלאות. So the gathering of יציאת מצרים, you know, when the people of Israel left Egypt, there was so many miracles, and you know, the whole heavens opened up, the people saw, you know, as we spoke about it in another class, that even the yeshivcha ra'ata yoter ma'asher yechezkel ben buzi. He said that everybody saw sights that were more than what Yechezkel, Ezekiel, the prophet saw. And he saw a lot, as we know, the chariot and the angels and everything. So we'll continue. The Zohar says, Rabbi Shimon, Zichrono Livracha, says, באותו זמן שיעוררו המתים של העולם והזדמנו בארץ הקדושה, יקומו חילות חילות כולם על ארץ הגליל. He says, when the resurrection of the dead, you know, will start, you know, שיעוררו המתים, you know, יעוררו is meant to wake up. That means they're sleeping, they're not really dead, you know. וישנה עפר יקוצו, right? It says that the people that sleeps in the dirt, underground in the grave will wake up. And all of a sudden it says Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai that many armies will come to fight in the Galil. They say that, you know, as we said, in the Valley of Megiddo, that's where the word Armageddon, in Aram and Megiddo, right, fighting in Megiddo. And he says, Mishum shesham atid melech ha-mashiach litgalot, Mishum shehu chalko shel Yosef, ושם נשברו בראשונה, ומשם התחילו לגלות מכל מקומותיהם להתפזר בין העמים. So Rabbi Shimon here is speaking about, as we said, the first Mashiach will be Mashiach ben Yosef, that will handle all the wars in the world, and then immediately thereafter will be Mashiach ben David, to be the king of the world. So he says here, העתיד הקדוש ברוך הוא לגלות רזים עמוקים של התורה בזמן שיבוא מלך המשיח. He says, the Zohar says that, you know, in the future of that, when it's happening, HaKadosh Baruch Hu will reveal so many secrets, meaning that, you know, the secrets of the Torah. And when it happened, when the Mashiach ben David, Melech HaMashiach, will come, as he says in the book of Isaiah, in chapter 11, Shemalha Aretz De'a, Et Adonai Kamayim Laya Mechasim. He says that, you know, the knowledge of the world will be so amazing that people will stop learning Torah and they'll be knowledgeable of all the secrets of the Torah. And in the book of Jeremiah, Lamed Aleph, he says, "Velo ilmedu od ishet reu ve ishet echav lemor da'u et Adonai ki kulam yadu oti lemi katan ve'ad gedolam amen ken yiratzon." So the Zohar revealed to us that everybody, even the children and everybody, will have such knowledge of Hashem. There will be actually, there is no need to study from anybody. Everybody will know everything. Imagine you can know the entire Gemara and all the secrets of the world, the Zohar, and everything that the Torah was hiding from us in the coded messages, and of course with everything that has to do with the skips of letters, and really the fundamental coded messages in the Torah and the words that it's written in. So he says in the Zohar, it speaks about Vezehu Shebarua Baalea Mishnah. You know, the Tanaim said something amazing. Dor Sheben David Ba, Anshe Chayil Yesovevu Meir Leir Velo Yochonenu, Vierechet Yimasu. He says, the Tanaim says, you know, when Mashiach Ben David will come, you know, Anshe Chayil, militaries, will go from town to town and there will be no mercy. They will go and start destroying, and all the sinners, you know, will not basically fear anything, and they will disrespect the Sofrim, the Chochmat Sofrim Tisrach, V'tehi Ha'emet Ne'ederet V'gefen Titen Piriyah V'hayayin Yeh Bo'yoker. He says, in those days, everything will be chaotic, and there will be no respect to Torah. And even though we just said that, you know, everybody will have such knowledge of Torah, and he said the truth will be missing, will disappear from the world, and everything will be very expensive. You know, it's really, that's exactly what's happening now. Today, I don't know if you notice anywhere in the world, but especially in Israel, apartment that used to cost $100,000, $300,000, today they're $1 million, $2-3 million, a tiny little place anywhere in Israel, Tel Aviv, Jerusalem, you name it. You know, nobody can afford, the young generation cannot even afford buying homes. You know, all the homes that have been purchased are usually come from, you know, Jews from all over the world that securing their space in Israel, and there is, you know, such a rush to build so many, and we're talking about the last 10, 15 years already, it's not new. He says, Va'atid HaKadosh Baruch Hu, ללבוש בגדי נקמה על אדום שהחריבו את ביתו ושרפו את היכלו והגלו את כנסת ישראל בין העמים. So he says in those days הקדוש ברוך הוא will revenge all the Edomites, which is, you know, today the Christians. Edom from come from Esav, Adom, and originally originated with Yefet, the son of Noah. And he says that Hashem will take revenge about what they did to the people of Israel. You know, as we know, the Crusaders killed millions, more than 11 million Jews, you know, and when they were fighting with, you know, the Jews all over the world, and the Arabs and such, and of course they destroyed the temple, as we know, the second temple, and they caused this latest galut, the exile that we're in right now. We've been in exile right now for 1951 years. אנחנו כרגע בגלות האחרונה של אדום, שנקראת גלות אדום, 1951 שנה. And Hashem will revenge that, and it says that he would do such nekamat olamim, it would be war, revenge for worlds to come, and all the worlds that were, you know, before, meaning that he will wake up every one of them, punish them, and kill them again. וכל, he says, מלאים מהרוגי עמים, ולקרוא לכל עוף השמיים עליהם, וכל חיות הבר יזונו מהם, 12 חודשים, ועוף השמיים 7 שנים. He says that Hashem will resurrect all the wicked people of Edom from the destruction of the temple to today, and will kill them all, and the animal, he will call upon all the animals, like, you know, the lions and hyenas, every animal that eats flesh will come and start eating all these people. It will take 12 months for them to finish to devour all this, and for the birds that eat flesh, like the eagle and all the other, you know, other animals that eat flesh, it will take them 7 years. Because, you know, the animal goes first, then the birds come. We see that always in nature. It's the evolution of any animal that's been hunted. They come first, the animal that hunts, whether it's the, you know, lioness, or whether it's any tigers, or any of those hyenas, or wolves, or pack, or whatever it is. They come first, they eat, then they leave, then the birds come and eat it. And then, of course, the lower food chain comes and eat that, and then at the end there's just the carcass, you know, that nobody really can eat. And then we see here that after those 7 years, עד שלא תסבול הארץ את הניבול שלהם, it says it will get to a point that the land could not absorb this, the disgust of this dead carcasses. זהו שכתוב, this is written in the book of Isaiah in chapter 34, כי זבח לאדוני בבצרה וטבח גדול בארץ אדום, עד שאותם לבושים יטמעו, שכתוב, וכל מלבושי הגאלתי. So we see here, really after all said and done, when Hashem will wake up the children of Edom, meaning the Christian, and make the revenge on them, and after the wild animals and beasts eat their flesh, and the birds will eat their flesh, it will take 12 months and 7 years for the bird, 12 months for the animal, 7 for the bird. After that, you know, it will be basically the end of Mamlechet Edom. It will be the end of the kingdom of the Edomites. And we say here, Chochmat Sofrim Tisrach. You know, we said earlier that even though Mashiach is, you know, will be here, Mashiach ben Yosef in the world, and we'll see that the knowledge will be so immense that everybody will know the entire secrets of the Torah, from young to old. And it says, even though Chochmat Sofrim Tisrach Benehem, Bechol Ir Veir Bechol Makom Sheyisrael Mefuzarim Benehem Ben Melachim. It says that the wisdom of the Jews will not be respected wherever they are in the world. וחזרו ערב רב רועים על ישראל. And of course it says that the ערב רב, you know, meaning the so-called other nation, will be controlling the people of Israel. As he says, צון הקדוש ברוך הוא, שנאמר in the book of Ezekiel, ואתן צוני צון מרעית אדם אתם, ואין להם יכולת לעשות טוב עם תלמידי חכמים. He says, in those 40 years as we spoke, you know, about the chaos in the world, that the Jewish people will be led by the non-Jews and be controlled by them. They will not do good, meaning the rulers, with the Talmidei Chachamim, with the people of knowledge, which is the Jewish people. And it says, "Olam afuch ra'iti, elyonim lemata v'tachtonim lemala." It says, we see, like today, it will be an upside-down world. In reality, what does it mean? אומר, שדברים שאין להם בכלל היגיון, קורים ודברים של היגיון לא קורים. And he says, what do you mean, like, you know, things that makes no sense happen? We take an example. Today you have, you know, Arab women in the government of Israel and men and Arab in the governments of all the nations in the world. They support openly. They support terrorism. They support, you know, Holocaust denier. They support everything that they want to support against their own nation and countries where they were elected. You know, if you're elected in America, for an example, or in Israel, when you become a congressman or woman, you raise your hand and you swear to protect America or to protect Israel or England, wherever country you are. But in reality, they do not do that, meaning that really they're prisoners, you know, to be voted to Congress to protect the Constitution in America or Israel or anywhere maybe and act against it or the rule of law. What do? You really, it's considered treason. But yet, it happens. That's what the Zohar says. He says, "Olam afuch ra'iti, elyonim lemata v'tachtonim lemala." Meaning that, you know, the low of the lowest are leaders, and the true leaders are the subordinates, the lower part. V'anshe chayil v'yerechet mesovivim me'ir le'ir. It says, soldiers will go from town to town, and they have no mercy. And they start destroying each other, and they don't give them a lot of space to live, and this time will be very measured in a small amount of time, and all this revenge will not be a victory. At the end, afilu chaye sha'a, even he says that it will come to a point that people will not live within 1 hour. Chas v'chalila, the chaos that will ensue in those 40 years before the resurrection of the dead. As we said before, for the people that joined us lately, he says in the beginning, he said, what is the order? He says, first come Beit HaMikdash, the temple will come before the gathering of the people of Israel. The gathering of people of Israel will be before the resurrection of the dead. And of course, the resurrection of the dead will be the last one. So here, we see something amazing as the Zohar speak of this order and what's going to happen. The Zohar continue and it says, and then, how do people will know what's about to happen? It says, Zot patach ve'amar, al har gavoa, ali lach mevaseret Zion. Al har gavoa ze vaday har ha'ivrin. So it says that, you know, what is the har Zion? Some say, the Zohar says that there is a place, as we know, Moshe Rabbeinu was buried on. It's called Har Nevo. Is the mountain that Moshe Rabbeinu climbed, and from here he was gave the opportunity to see the entire land of Israel, and of course all the prophecies between him and Rabbi Akiva, the whole 1300 years. And he says this is really where the Har Gavoa, he says Mevaser Tzion, it will be the announcement of the building of the Yerushalayim in Beit HaMikdash, Makom Shemoshe Nikvar Bo. It says this will be, the Shekhinah will come there, and Tevaser La'olam, you know, the Shekhinah, the holiness will come and will tell the world. Aval Hakol Hu Mevaser Tzion Zehu Chefzi Ba'eshet Natan Ben David Em HaMashiach. It says that, of course, Eshet Natan Ben David will be the mother of the Mashiach. And it says that the Mashiach names will be Menachem Bar Amiel. And it says, Vehi tetze vetevaser vehi bichlal mevaser Tzion. They call the mother of Eshet Natan Ben David the Mevaser Tzion, meaning that she tells about Zion. You know, Tzion is another name for Yerushalayim. And as we said in the past, people that speak Hebrew understand, Tzion has the first letter, Tzadik. If we take the Tzadik out of Tzion, we have left with Yavan, with Greek. You know, when they took the Tzadikim, the righteousness out of Yerushalayim, the Greeks came and destroyed Yerushalayim. So it says here, continuing the Zohar, it says, Bota sha'a, elu ba'ala Torah yunichbadim. And then everything will change. When the Mashiach will come, there'll be so much respect for people that know and study Torah. And it says, those are the people that throughout, before that, they suffered so much, you know? As we see today, they always blame the Haredim, and they blame the Rabbanim, and they blame the Yeshivot. Oh, you guys are doing nothing. But in reality, I want to challenge each and every one of you to try to sit in the yeshiva for 16 hours every day and study. See how long you last. And how much, you know, unfortunately, they make so much heartache and pain and insult to those, you know, yeshiva boys, telling them that they're ochlei chinam, like they get something for nothing. But in reality, without this combination of both Tzevaot Hashem and Tzevaot Israel, it's very hard to win. When you don't have both combination of warriors of God, we would call the yeshivot and the rabbanim and the Torah study people, it's very hard to win war with just the war of, you know, conventional war. Because, you know, many miracles happened to Israel. By the way, Israel is the only nation that won all the wars, regardless of how it began, with no, you know, even a shred of opportunity, or Chas v'Chalila, even nobody predicted that we can win a six-day war, or the independent war, or, you know, Yom Kippur war, or Lebanon, or Gaza, everything. You know, we're right, we're still here, right? So it says here that in those days, all of a sudden, it will be like, as we said before, that the people that learned Torah, it was like, you know, feeling the pain of a pregnant woman. You know, they say that a pregnant woman has to say Hagomel, right? Acharei Aleda, Isha Tzicha Lagid Hagomel. Question is asked, why a pregnant woman have to say Gomel? Hagomel, it has to be said, they say that the pregnant woman, when she gives birth, she reaches the pain of the opening of hell. She reaches the doors of hell with the pain. And it's almost death. And when it's all Baruch Hashem done and passed, she has to say Hagomel when the Torah is read, after the Torah is read, either on Monday, Thursday, or Shabbat. And thank Hashem for Shegmalani Kol Tuv, you know, that He really did good with me, even though I was about to, Chas v'Chalila, you know, unfortunately, we see even with Rachel. Rachel was in so much pain, she passed away, giving birth to Binyamin. Ben Oni, she called him, you know, the son of my pain. And of course, you know, we know that Yaakov will change it, you know, to Binyamin and not Ben Oni. And we see here, so those people that stuck with Hashem, regardless of the pain and the insult and all, they will be nichbadim umiyad Hashem. It says that they will be so respectful. And then the verse that comes in Tehillim, Adonai lamabul yashav. What does it mean? Adonai lamabul yashav. It says, HaKadosh Baruch Hu will punish the wicked, like He did with the flood, with the Mabul of Noach, which is this week parasha, as we know. Why Hashem destroyed the world? Because there was such wickedness in the world that Hashem says this is not humane. People should not behave like this. If they chose that, they should not be part of this world and creation. And we, all of us, are people that came after the Mabul. Now, everybody that was by the Mabul was destroyed. By the way, it's good to mention here that, you know, the person that lived the longest in the history of the world, you know, many people think it was Metushelach, the grandfather of Noah, that lived 969 years. But actually, Midrash Kohelet says that it was Cain. Cain was killed in the flood, in the Mabul. He lived for 1656 years. Amazing. So here continue, says that when Hashem says, Adonai la Mabul Yashav, is Yashav la Rashaim, he'll be back to punish the, what we call, the wicked. Of course, there will be no flood, because Hashem promised there will be no flood anymore in the world. And He gave us, of course, the rainbow, the keshet that Hashem natan lanu. What is the rainbow? Why is the rainbow? Rainbow is the sign for the flood. So as we know, the flood started on the 17th of Cheshvan, and it lasted for 40 days. So in reality, majority of the flood was in the month of Kislev, which is the month of Hanukkah, and the sign of Kislev is a keshet, right? The keshet is what we call the sign zodiac of, which is from the Gemara, by the way, it's not Christian. The bow is the keshet, is the sign of Kislev, and that's hence why Hashem gave the sign for the flood not to happen again, the keshet. And of course we know today, Chas v'chalila, there's a group of people that use this sign as their pride, but in reality it was exactly because their acts, they were demolished and destroyed from the world. The flood came because of those, Chas v'chalila, horrific sex crimes. So we see here that HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he says that he will punish those wicked exactly כמו שנפתחו מעיינות תהום רבה וארובות השמיים נפתחו בימי המבול. He said that the punishment will be like exactly what happened. You know, the core of the earth came out, you know, the lava and the magma and the heat, which is, by the way, part of the hell process. And the water from above, ארובות השמיים נפתחו. That's how the wicked people will be punished, just like in the days of the flood. אף כאן יתעוררו דינים עליהם למעלה ולמטה. He says that the judgment will come from below and above, עד שאין סוף ותכלית. Until the end, and there is no... תכלית is the essence of everything. Will be all demolished. And וכל הביזויים והבושה שעשו אומות עבדי הכוכבים ומזלות של העולם, לשם השם ולעמו, וכמה חרפות שסבלו ישראל מהם עד שם אדוני. It says that Hashem will punish all this wicked people, as we said, both the whole world that went against Israel. We see that today there's anti-Semitism all over the world. Is you know, it's almost at the levels of the Holocaust today. You know, the first thing that the Holocaust started was with, first and foremost, the BDS, right? The boycotting of Israel started on campuses. You know, what we call the smart kids of the world that go to study. Slowly, they were completely were engaged in boycotting Israel and Jews, and then destroying the Jewish, you know, people and the markets and their stores and all the merchant. And we see that, you know, it's happening today. We have this chaos even in America. There's so many attacks on Jews all over the world. It's exactly the hatred. But Hashem will punish all of them, Be'ezat Hashem, soon. As we can see, it's coming very, very soon. And Hashem will revenge the nekama. He says, HaKadosh Baruch Hu mikulam, yikach HaKadosh Baruch Hu nekama. Ve'azeh nikra etzlam, nokem Adonai ve'noter uva'al chema. You know, he said that HaKadosh Baruch Hu noter. Noter means, you know, when somebody does something bad to you, years goes by and you still keep it inside, and you promise to make a revenge on them, you know? You know, see here that Hashem is Baal Chema. Chema is very, very, very chaotic anger. Bachodesh HaRishon, this thing will come upon them. What's Bachodesh HaRishon? Mihu Rishon, Zenisan. So it says that Hashem will take the revenge on the wicked on the month of Nisan. Why Nisan? As we know, the people of Israel left Egypt on Nisan. אז אנחנו רואים פה שגם הגאולה תהיה בניסן. שם הולידה אותה חיה לקיים מה שפרשו בעלי המשנה, בניסן נגלו וניסן עתידים להיגאל. So as we said, the תנאים revealed to us, remember the תנאים, they're not regular person or people or רבנים. They're giants of giants that was almost half an angel, half a person. They could connect the worlds, they can... resurrect people from the dead. They are the one that gave us the essence of the Gemara, and of course the Amoraim came and explained the Mishnah of what those Tanaim wrote. So he said that this Tanaim taught us that, you know, we were once redeemed in Nisan, the month of Nisan, and in the future we'll be redeemed in the month of Nisan. By the way, Nisan is the only kosher car you can buy. It's in the Torah, right? Nisan, like the, it's a joke. You can laugh. Anyway, so let's continue. Vayomer ki yad al kes ya. And this is the hand of Hashem, and the throne of Hashem will be v'sham nishba le'avir me'olam zara'o shel Esav ve'amalekim. It says Hashem promised that he will remove. As remember, this is one of the mitzvot in the Torah, et zecher Amalek. We are obligated to destroy the Amalekites. You know, who are the Amalekites? We know, of course, it's the Persian today, right? We have some of the people of Europe, right? We have some of the Christians. You know, Amalek is many different nations. that came to destroy the people of Israel. We call Amalek Hagagi. Haman was one of Amalek, for example. Hitler is one of Amalek. Yimach Shma V'Shem Zichram. You know, so we see here that Hashem promised to eliminate and destroy the Amalekites, and he will do that on the month of Nisan. It says, the Zohar continues, says in the book of Devarim, in the book of Deuteronomy, Parashat Vayetchanan says, Patach Ve'amar. As he says in Isaiah, in Be'eretz Mitzrayim, he said that the people of the world will gather, the Jewish people of the world will gather from all four corners of the world. And he says, V'haya Bayom Ahu, what is that day? What's the Bayom Ahu in this day? Ela oto yom hayadu al kadosh baruch hu kemo she'ne'emar v'haya yom echad hu yivada la'ashem od bayom ahu she'ne'emar bayom bo gog al admat eretz yisrael itaka b'shofar. So it says here, when the forces of Gog, you know, Gog is the king of Magog, you know, the nations of Gog, some say it's America. And the king of Magog at the time will come to Israel, and that day Hashem will have Mashiach, the prophet, the last prophet that exists in our life today, which is Eliyahu Navi, will blow in the horn and will announce the Mashiach, and then Hashem then will itka b'shofar gadol, you know, the same shofar that was blown on Matan Torah, and it says Vayilach shofar. You know, and the shofar went ahead and it was stronger and stronger and stronger. And as we know, there was no echo, right? When you blow shofar anywhere in the desert, there's an echo. The echo never came back, meaning that the Torah will forever will continue, and this shofar will come in the future. Malanu bo im hu yom gadol o katan. The question is asked, the Zohar says, is this going to be a significant day, a small one or a big one? He says, "Ele ota shofar ha'elyon shebo yotzim ha'avadim lecherut tamid, v'zehu ha'yovel. Ha'yovel ha'elyon v'gadol hu, v'kshezeh mitorer al cherut shel ha'olamim mitorerim bo, v'hu nikra shofar gadol." So he says that, you know, the shofar, as we said before, will be on the, it's called the Yovel. Yovel is the 50th year's jubilee. It will be a day of jubilee. And it will bring upon the freedom from all these other nations and all the chaos that we have in the world today. And it will blow in such power that the whole world will shake and will hear and fear Hashem. And it says here, Amar lahem HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Hizdamnu linkom et nikmat benai, Shetei nekamot ani atid litparea mehem. It says, because, as we know, the people of Edom destroyed the Second Temple, and the people of Ishmael destroyed the first temple, Hashem will have two revenge on them. It says, Nekama achat shel 600 merkavot. It says, there will be 600 angels' chariots that will come from the heavens. You know, there is Malachi Seraphim. There is the angels of fire that will come. 600 carriages, the merkavot of fire, shehilva lesar hagadol shel Mitzrayim kedei lilachem bekrav beYisrael. As we know, that Pharaoh had those chariots coming against Israel when they left out of Egypt, and of course they were all destroyed and drowned in the Red Sea, with the Sea of Reeds, Yam Suf. The word Suf comes from the word Sof. It was the end of those people, and the end of Pharaoh, and end of the entire Egypt, the Meitzarim, the tough time for the Jewish of people, the Israel that left Egypt. And he says, Shekatuv, Vayikach 600 rechev bachur v'chor rechev Mitzrayim. So, you know, it's measure for measure. Those 600 chariot of fire that will come from Shamayim to avenge the pain that they caused the Jewish people will be against the 600 chariot that Pharaoh took when he left. It says, 600 rechev bachur v'chol rechev Mitzrayim v'nekama achat shel abanim sheli she'etziku lahem ad achshav. It says, one revenge is because of this ongoing, you know, as we see today, the Arab world is non-stop, right? Always against the Jews, even though we started as good friends, as we know. As we said, Muhammad originally loved the Jews, and he even said, we are not the people that received the Torah, the people of the book, Alma Sefer, he called us. He asked the people that reads the Quran, go ask the Jews if you need any explanation. We never got the Torah. Unlike the Quran today, who's completely changed, that has nothing but hatred and killing. So we see here that a Kadosh Baruch Hu will revenge with those 600 chariot. And he says, "V'nekama achat shel abanim." This is a nekama against the children of Israel. And misham kach nidonu b'shnei dinim, echad b'mayim v'echad b'esh. Hashem will both punish them with water and fire, just like they did to the people of Israel. And he says that Nachal Kishon Gerafam ba'esh shekatuv ha'kochavim mimsolotehem. He says there will be Nachal Kishon. It's the river of Kishon, which, you know, will take them all in fire. Shekatuv ha'kochavim, with the stars, meaning that, you know, there are stars that will move from their course and destroy the Arab people all over the world. ובאותם כוכבים יש כוכב אחד שלא בא לאותה נקמה והתקלקל לעולמים שכאשר מתחיל להעיר באים שאר הכוכבים וולים אותו ואת כל סיעתו וכולם עובדים יחד כמו שנאמר אורו מרוז אמר מלאך השם. So he says, it's amazing, the Zohar says that there is one planet, one star that did not listen to Hashem in the past, and he's what we call, you know, other stars comes and, you know, basically destroy it, like consume the star into them, and all, it's called Oro Meruz. There is a war, you know, planet called Maroz, and we know that, you know, King Solomon knew about this Maroz. As it says, the angel of Hashem will destroy that. V'chi yesh reshut lemalach beze. He says, an angel can destroy a planet. Ela, zehu amalach shekatuv, v'isa amalach ha'elohim ha'olech lifne machane Israel. וזהו שכל הקרבות הן שלו, כי לא באו לעזרת השם כשיצאו ישראל במצרים. He says that this angel did not come, this planet and kochav that was supposed to come like with the rest of them to help the people of Israel when he left Egypt. There'll be an angel in charge to destroy this planet, just as the same angel that helped bring them out of Egypt. You know, as we know, it was the Michael. As you know, when Hashem wanted to punish the people of Israel after the sin, he says to Moshe, I'll send Malachi itcha, you know, Malachi, elech lefanechem. And Moshe refuses, no, I do not want Michael to come to be only one. I want you, Hashem, to lead us and be with us for the, you know, in the desert for the time that we need to be. And Hashem agreed. And it says that this angel, Ezrat Hashem Bagiburim, Imotam Shishim Giburim Shizdamnu Bekrav Im Sisra. We know, as we have, when the Sisera was fighting the people of Israel, and Devorah Neviah, Devorah the prophet, sent 60 Giburim, heroes, to fight him. And as we know, even though he was mighty, mighty, mighty with a huge military, the people of Israel won, and Sisera ending up running away and hiding, and actually not hiding, he kidnapped Yael in her tent. And the Zohar says that he actually, Chas v'Chalila, had her way, he raped her for 7 times that night. And Yael, of course, took revenge on him and killed him with the stick of the tent, and then cut his head off and brought it to the people of Israel. And from, by the way, this act of Chas v'Chalila, Sisera and Yael, that was not by Yael's will nor wish, but from that, the grandson will be none other than Rabbi Akiva. Rabbi Akiva was the grandson of Sisera, his father Yosef, who converted. It was the son of Yael, and from him came Rabbi Akiva. So that's when we say, Me'az yatsa matok, that even from bad good comes. So we'll continue. We have a few more minutes. He says that the malach hazeh hu sot shel kol hadinim vehakravot shel hamelech hem bereshuto. Ve'al ken amar malach Adonai, v'zeh shekatuv, hamalach hagoel oti. You know, in the book of Bereshit, we have hamalach hagoel, this angel will save me. Amazing. Just one angel can defeat the entire world, you know, that coming against Israel. V'zeh atid liyod elyon, v'nichbad le'atid elyon. ובזה יתגדל השם הקדוש, ובזה עתיד הקדוש ברוך הוא להתפרע מהעמים עובדי כוכבים ומזלות. He said, with this angel Hashem will take his revenge on all the nations that did not, you know, believe in him. As we know, Hashem gave all the other nations just 7 laws, you know. There are 7 laws that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave the people of Noah, you know, as we said, the 7 white laws. And we can see it in the Chumash. Get to it in a second here. It says in Parashat Noah, after Hashem destroyed the world and the people of the nation that came out to the world, none of the Jewish people, he gave them 7 mitzvot Noach, the 7 Noahite laws. It was first the not to work Avodah Zarah, not to work other gods, to believe in Hashem, and not to curse Hashem, and not to murder or kill each other, and not to have Chaz v'chalil, we call Gilui Aroyot, which is the sexual transgressions against all, and not to steal, and of course to have a system of courts, and not to have ever minachai, not to chaz v'chalila take an axe and chop off a leg of an ox and eat it and leave the axe to walk with 3 legs. So those are the 7 white laws that Kadosh Baruch Hu gave to the goyim, and because they did not keep it, Hashem says that his angel will revenge there all these nations. And he says here, as the prophet Yechezkel says in chapter 38, Vehitgadalti vehitkadashti ובכל העולם הלכו עד שהגיעו עד רבי שמעון. He says that the whole world will be this, and we know that רבי שמעון, you know, was the last one to have this, you know, התגלות, this revelation by Hashem that he gave him the secret. So, and of course, he sent an angel. They say Eliyahu Navi came and taught him and his son Elazar in the cave for 13 years. And they said there was also other angels like Raziel, the angel that came with all the secrets, in Sodot Raz El, which is Sodot Hashem. And he says, Uma Israel Umrim, Israel will say, Vayamru lo nuchal ad asher yasfu kol ha'adarim. The people of Israel will say, we cannot start until all the Jewish people are gathered from all over the world, even though, you know, meaning that the people of below and the people of above, meaning that the dead people has to be resurrected. And only then, v'galelu et ha'even, this what we call even ha'shtiya, the even shel ha'tashtit. As we know today, the stupid Arabs have the their mask, you know, mask is from the word masecha, they mask the truth, they cover the truth. They have built a shrine above the stone in Mount, Temple Mount, which Harabait, where the original, you know, the whole entire water of the world was stopped by this stone. As we know, there was actually 4 stones placed all over the world to stop the water from coming below to the land and flood the whole world. There's no such thing as global warming and all this, you know, nonsense that you hear from a lot of politicians. He says, only then, when all the people of Israel will gather, the vivatlu oto hadin hakasheh shel oto hayom shesholet al pi ha'be'er, meaning that of course this arrow will be removed from Har Habayit and from the entire land of Israel. That's why, by the way, the Arab's name Ishmael, meaning Ishmael, at the acharit hayamim, at the end of days, the Arabs will listen to Hashem and remove themselves from Israel. The one that do it nicely will go, and the other one will be destroyed and killed. He says, only then we are nimtzet ota be'er imanu bagalut, shemitgala be'er azot vezot ha'even shesholetet aleha, miyad v'ishkenu atzon. Mishkenu atzon, meaning, you know, the tzon is the people of Israel, where, you know, we have our shepherd, which is Hashem. Moshe was our shepherd, as we know, in the desert. And v'atid ha'kadosh baruch hu besof ha'yamim le'achzir et Israel le'eretz ha'kdosha v'lechanes ota min ha'galut, ומיהם סוף הימים אותה שהיא אחרית הימים. So we'll finish with that. So Baruch Hashem, we see that all the signs that we see in the world today is part of this last 40 years. But remember, there is a law that we always have to remember. As we know, it was written to us and give it to us. It says, Amar HaKadosh Baruch Hu, שותים הם המחשבים את קץ המשיח, דבר שלא גיליתי לעולם, שנאמר in the book of Isaiah, Isaiah says, כי יום נקם בליבי הלב לפה לא גילה, ואתם משתדלים לחשב את הקץ שלי. We are not allowed to guess when is Mashiach coming, or when, which day, it's forbidden for us. And we want to just, again, be part of this, so you have to believe in it. Every moment of the day you have to ask for it, you have to teach it, and Be'ezat Hashem, we all merit Mashiach in our life. I want to wish all of you, for the people here and the people that came to watch us online, Shabbat Shalom, and Be'ezat Hashem, this Parashat Noach will be the last parasha we read before Mashiach, and Be'ezat Hashem, we will be redeemed shortly. Shabbat Shalom, and again, the class will be posted on our website, neshatorah.org. Please share with everybody else. Shabbat Shalom and Mevorach. Thank you.